Hey, you guys, I'm on a road trip.
Hi, guys. I'm here with Chelsea this morning.
And I'm here with Maia.
She has been kind enough to offer her time to talk a little bit about what it's like to be a lab manager
in a research lab in psychology.
My name is Maia, and I work in a cognitive development and communication lab at the University of Wisconsin.
My name is Chelsea. I was a lab manager for 2 years in a research lab at the University of Michigan. Primarily, we did stuff with little babies, so it was really fun. It was the funnest part.
There's a lot of things that, you know, are involved in being a lab manager that some people might not think about. Something that I deal with a lot is trying to make sure that we have money to pay our participants, and I do a lot of data collection myself.
Most of the things I did were running participants, so collecting data from the families, interacting with parents, scheduling appointments, so calling families up and saying, would you like to come do our research?
I also do a lot of building of stimulus for administering to our participants. I also train undergrads.
Managing the undergrad research assistants, so managing their schedules, making sure they were doing their work. Also working very closely with the professor in charge of the lab and his graduate students who were doing research in the lab.
I'm also there to be an ear to grad students when they're freaking out about their projects, which sometimes happens.
Mm-hmm.
So what kinds of things did you like about being a lab manager?
I really liked having a lot of independence. The professor who was in charge of this lab was really generous and was really, you know, willing to let me sort of be in charge and do the things that I wanted to do. So
the people I work with really makes it a great job. The principal investigator of the lab, she is an amazing person, and she makes me want to come into work every day and make sure that I give it 110%.
He would be happy to let me sort of find my own tasks, so I would take on tasks like redesigning the web page. That was one thing that I did while I was there. So I really liked being able to have that independence, and then also collaborating with the grad students in, you know, designing studies and things like that.
Well, the grad students I work with, they are amazing, and it's always great to sort of bounce ideas off them and have their input on stuff and give input on their stuff. And then I also collect data with a lot of kids, so it's always fun to bring those kids in and just sort of hear their processes on, you know, solving like different math problems, which is what we do in our lab. So yeah, it's always fun.
So I know sometimes one of the delights of research, especially with little kids, is that they will sometimes say or do ridiculous things. Yeah. Do you have a good, funny kid research story?
I do, yeah. There was a kid in particular I was working with. I think he was probably about 5 or 6 years old. And, you know, usually when we bring families in, you know, parents have to fill out a lot of paperwork and, you know, give their consent. Usually, as the person running the study, we take that time to sort of build some rapport with the kid. This particular child, I approached him and, you know, started talking to him, and he just turns to me and says, I understand I was chosen for something. which was very adorable to hear such an adultly worded phrase come out of a small child's mouth. It was very cute.
That's awesome. So, yeah.
The kind of research that we do involves showing like videos to students and then you know, getting them to learn different math concepts. And of course we have, you know, different videos for different conditions, and some videos are a lot more boring than others. And so I happened to show the most boring one to a student one day. After the video was done, out of curiosity, I just asked her, oh, so what do you think of the video? And, you know, she took a minute and she said, well, the teacher in the video had really nice skin.
So clearly she had like been taught, you say something nice or don't say anything at all. So I know a lot of people sometimes take a break between undergrad and graduate school to be a lab manager. Mm-hmm. Can you talk a little bit about what are some of the things that being a lab manager prepares you for by the time you get to graduate school?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that's exactly why I wanted to be and chose to be a lab manager. I came to psychology research sort of very late in my undergraduate career. It wasn't until my junior or senior year that I really got involved in research. I realized, you know, maybe this is something I'm interested in, taking a leap and actually going to graduate school right now, not having a ton of experience is probably a bad idea. You know, maybe I should try to get a little more experience and figure out more about the research process.
You definitely get better at email communication, knowing how to communicate with the principal investigator, with collaborators, people in the administration.
Designing a research study, particularly working with little babies, it can be very tricky.
You also learn how to encounter basically every type of family that comes in. Difficult kids, easy kids, some really interesting parents. You get to learn how to communicate with all different types of people.
So getting a lot of experience in the design of research was a really great aspect of that.
You know, I've developed my skills in data entry and analysis, and that really helps with the workflow.
Having that experience of managing a research project, which is very important if you're going to go to grad school, you need to be able to do that because that's pretty much all you do as a grad student.
That's grad school.
Yep.
How does one go about finding a lab manager position?
The way that I got my position was I had been working with a graduate student as a research assistant for him. When I was about to graduate, he came to me and said, "Hey, my advisor is looking for a lab manager.
Gotcha.
Would you like a job?" And I said, "Yes, please.
Yes, please, I'll take that.
Please and thank you." The way I actually got the opportunity to work with him was that he was a teaching assistant in a class that I had taken, and he reached out to me and said, "You know, I'm looking for a research assistant. You know, you did well in this class. Would you like to do that?" And
cool.
So, you know, saying yes to those kinds of opportunities, you know, is always good. Yeah. Gets you more experience.
Yeah.
So,
always say yes, guys. Just always say yes until you have to say
no. I don't know about
no.
that.
Sometimes you have to say no.
Yes, you do.
Well, as always, thanks for watching. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more of these kinds of things. Thanks for watching. Bye. And look who I found.
Hello.
What?
What?